Hi, everybody. I'm Karl Podesta. I work as a high-performance computing technical specialist for Azure, and I'm happy to have you with me today to listen about some of the challenges our customers in manufacturing and engineering experience and how we can address some of those challenges with our platform. So manufacturers are being asked to visualize real-time products and product performance from anywhere, and that goes to our situation now with COVID-19, and many of us are working from home, and the expectations are still on us to work as we have been doing before from anywhere. We also need to understand what's happening more with physical products and use things like digital twins to really understand what could happen in those products and to really optimize the products a lot better. We also need to incorporate feedback from IoT, so devices that are now everywhere and information that's coming and data that's coming from those devices. We need to incorporate that data into the simulations and into the work that's happening so that we can develop better products and understand real world effects into the products that we're going to design and improve. And all of this is being asked to happen a lot quicker than ever before. You need to do this faster. But challenges can really hamper our ability to do all of that. So we typically are working with some sort of fixed system. We have a workstation under our desk. We have a bunch of computers in a server room somewhere. And it's been an investment that we've made, but suddenly a new workload has come in and we need to do it faster than we need to do it before. We don't have the capacity to do it. And it's an opportunity that's been missed. And then other times, maybe the work has not been as busy as we've expected it to. So a number of projects happen together. They often finish together. And then some of the resources that we've made investments in are just sitting there not being used. Again, another missed opportunity. And again, how do we collaborate better amongst all of this with our colleagues spread across the world, spread across different locations? So we've really got a geographical disparity here going on as well. All of these obstacles together really make it difficult for us to be able to do our work. So in addition to those challenges, transformation of our business is also requiring a next level of computing power. So some of the items that you're seeing on the slide are really illustrating how we have more data than ever before, how we will have more data than ever before, and how we're also expected to learn and incorporate that data into the simulations and into the work that we're trying to understand. So we believe that that transformation can also happen through simulation. This is a real opportunity, especially with the cloud, for us to bring simulation to everyone, everywhere. And that means that we can also enhance the traditional factory type of mode that we're doing, the traditional products that we're developing with these new digital capabilities. We can really develop new products on top of that and monetize on the back of that as well, thus creating new value, new business for us. And this is also what the transformation is really about. So combining high performance computing and simulation with all of the other capabilities of the cloud, including IoT, artificial intelligence and machine learning, this is the opportunity that we all have. So thinking about the engineer's workflow, we might start off using a workstation where we have to develop the product initially to do some pre-processing, to develop a 3D model and interact with it. Then spinning off to a simulation or an analysis or multiple simulations or analysis that may even take many hours, many days to do. And then we're coming back maybe to the workstation to analyze the results of that process. Maybe after all of that has been completed as well, we're then moving on to developing product brochures for that. So maybe doing some rendering of what the final product may look like and publishing images for customers or colleagues to look at alike. And how about integrating deep learning, machine learning, or artificial intelligence techniques into that? So what about all of the data and all of the simulations we've generated? Are there smarter ways to do that? And could machine learning really help us? Integrating that into the workflow that we've just described is part of what can be done together in the cloud. So how can Microsoft and Azure in particular help some of this transformation? Well, it's different in terms of providing on-demand, extensible, and scalable resources to aid that transformation. And all of this together with unique capabilities that fits in Microsoft Azure. So when we talk about being on-demand, you want to be able to scale up that compute and simulation power when you need it, as much as you need it, wherever you need it. You also want it to be extensible. So you want it to complement the investments you've already made in systems on-premise. Maybe you only need this power for a particular project or a particular simulation at a given time, and not for the rest of the year. Another capability is it being scalable. So you really want it to be able to scale up and down easily. The whole thing has to be easy to do, and it has to leverage all of these advanced technology capabilities that we have together in Microsoft Azure. And that includes at the operating system level, at the hardware level, at the application level, and of course, through our partnerships and vendor ecosystem that we work closely with. So here's a suggested path that you might be able to take to make this happen. So one of the things that you can do to get started is to simply lift and shift or clone to cloud. And that involves taking applications or data that you've already got, spinning up some resources in the cloud and getting them done in that manner. So this can already bring some benefits to you in terms of geographic reach and scalability and choosing the type of machines that you want. And this really works for some of our customers as things stand. Then as you start to develop things a bit more, you may really need to leverage the existing investments you've made, have a hybrid workflow that encompasses storage, compute, capabilities that you have already developed in your site, and really expanding those to the cloud as part of a whole workflow. You can go one further and really do the whole workflow in the cloud, and that includes pre- and post-processing workstations, multiple machines to run the simulations, and capabilities such as machine learning, IoT, afterwards to be able to develop and leverage more value from the simulations that you've done. And finally, you can also leverage unique capabilities in Azure to do cloud native style workflows. So really, it's about choosing the right workflow for you, for your users, for your situation. Let's take a closer look at one of our compute offerings specially designed for HPC. The Intel Xeon Scalable Processor, codenamed Skylake, used with the Azure HC series, is designed to meet the demanding requirements of HPC in the cloud, along with pre-installed and configured tuning management software. Users can take advantage of a common code base across on-premises and public cloud infrastructure, including Intel hardware acceleration technologies like AVX 512 and common HPC management and optimization software. You can have confidence that all of the Intel components you'll use are optimized for maximum performance, and that includes storage, interconnect, compute, and memory. Beyond the hardware components of compute, storage, and networking, there's unique capabilities in Microsoft Azure to be able to leverage these in an easy way. Two tools that we're highlighting today that are also free to use are Azure Batch and Azure Cycle Cloud. And these are both methods you can use to automatically create clusters and machines together in the cloud, turn them on when you need them, turn them off when you don't need them, and to do so automatically. So whether you prefer to interact with this through code or whether you prefer to have a nice interface to be able to do it that you can share with users who are unfamiliar with using the cloud but familiar with using clusters and workstations, then these are two tools that are a great choice that you can also integrate with your workflows. Microsoft Azure is built for HPC. Only Microsoft has all of the pieces of the puzzle to fit together to help you in your journey to the cloud, wherever you may currently be at. This includes a comprehensive portfolio of capabilities, compute, storage, networking, infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, software as a service, and supercomputer style capabilities to meet your simulations, whatever scale. We also make it easy to transition. So we have a number of native tools to make it easy to spin up these resources, to put them together into workflows that includes hybrid capabilities with your on-premise investments. We also have intelligent cloud capabilities. So you want to join and combine high-performance computing with AI, machine learning, and IoT, really to leverage the value that the cloud can bring by combining these solutions together. We have an extensive partner ecosystem, including our partner Intel, who we've highlighted here today. And finally, it's the investment in HPC. And this includes at all levels of Microsoft, from engineering, customer support, sales, development, to really go all in on HPC in the cloud. Azure is productive, hybrid, intelligent, and trusted. We hope that today we've helped you understand some of the challenges that manufacturing and engineering customers have and how we're able to address those with Azure and Azure High Performance Computing Solutions. Thanks for listening. Thanks for your time. Take care and hope to see you soon.